This is REZ-2021-26, Ridgecrest and Bucky Ford, and the current zoning is approximately 37 acres, is into heavy manufacturing, and the request is for R10 suburban residential. Motivation is to change it to 114 lot subdivision. Currently served by county utilities in the area, which was put in place for the Arglass manufacturing plant to the east of this property. Concerning the comprehensive plan, it is within the urban service area and an industrial character area. However, there are no recommended residential zones within the character area of the comprehensive plan. In November of 2020, this property was rezoned from EA to M2 for that manufacturing purposes, for the construction of an industrial facility to service both current and potential future industrial interest in the area. With this request, be mindful of the adjacent M2 zonings to the north, east, and south of the property, the noise and intensity of Arglass current manufacturing process and any future processes, and the future growth of any manufacturing within the area as it is in industrial activity character area. We have received verbal opposition from the industrial authority regarding any residential and the potential to lose manufacturing level properties for them to solicit even growth for that. You'll see here we proposed 115 residential lots at an R10 density, 10,000 square feet. So overall, planning comments request being consistent with the conference plan. The CRC had no technical objections to the plan.
Are there any questions from the commissioners for staff?
Well, Jackie, would you repeat what you, the words you said about industrial part? What was your input?
So far, they have voiced some initial opposition. They were made aware of this request. They're concerned about losing property already zoned M2, as it is a higher classification, and the marketability of surrounding properties and how it bases it. Again, losing property of this magnitude, 37 acres, zoned M2, which originally proposed for more industrial.
I'm just curious, so if the subdivision was sitting here in the glass cover inside of the building behind them, what triggers would they have? Would they be buffers required for that glass company? I'm just curious.
Yes, sir. According to GLPC, an intensive service such as an M2 manufacturing zone located adjacent to any residential in case R10 would have to be a minimum buffer area of 40 feet between the zone officials. So I would essentially put a 40-foot buffer all the way around the property. Now that buffer could be reduced with the installation of a 6 to 8 foot fence to 50%, so down to a 20-foot buffer area. But that would be a minimum. Again, we have received numerous noise complaints in our last currently from residents to the north across 84 North in the locking section. So it's a much greater distance than the proposed subdivision here. And that's why buffer considerations would be recommended. We typically don't have buffer recommendations between R10 going in because it's usually manufacturing coming in that triggers it. But in this case, buffer would be recommended to mitigate any noise from the surrounding area.
Any other questions for staff? All right, we'll move to the public hearing portion for this case. Is there anyone here this evening that would like to speak in favor of this case? If so, please come forward. Is there anyone here who would like to speak against this case? Therefore, the public hearing portion is now closed. I will ask for a motion from the commissioner.
REZ-2021-26. It's a request to rezone this property from heavy manufacturing to a suburban density residential R10 zoning. This request is clearly out of character with the current use of the area. It's been found to be inconsistent with the comprehensive plan, and I would like to make a motion that we recommend denial.
Thank you, Mr. Wells. There's a motion for denial from Commissioner Wiles. Is there a second? Second by Commissioner Willis. All in favor of the motion to deny, please raise your right hand. All those opposed to the motion to deny.
Thank you for investing more.
All right, I'll repeat that. All commissioners in favor of supporting the motion by Commissioner Wiles to deny this request, please raise your right hand. One, two, three, four, five.
Six.
Six. All those against the motion to deny, please raise your right hand. Three.
I'm going to stand.
And one abstention from Commissioner Bailey. Did you get that, Ms. Reedy? The motion to deny is carried. Next case, Judy.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.